So join me as we pray in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Lord, be with you. So let us prepare ourselves then to celebrate the great gift of marriage and the great gift of this Eucharist that we share this afternoon. Let us pray. Be attentive to our prayers, O Lord, and in your kindness, pour out your grace on these your servants, Amanda and Casey, that coming together before your holy altar, they may be confirmed in love for each other, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. So please be seated now as we listen to God's word. God made them male and female, and that is why a man should leave his father and mother, and the two will become one body. They are no longer two then, but one flesh. Therefore, let no man ever separate what God has joined. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated for a moment. Today we hear that gospel. One of those gospels that we've heard many times. One of the most essential gospels of the liberty. How God made man and woman to become one. So they would no longer be two, Jesus says, but one flesh. And let no man separate what God has joined. So what we do today is something that no one should ever separate. One of the greatest gifts that God gave to man and to woman was the gift of each other. And certainly we can see that gift present in these two. I've had the pleasure of working with a man in Casey preparing for the marriage. And so I always do this little questionnaire with couples. Some of you have done that, I'm sure. Hopefully, you prepare to get married, unless you've got the easy way out. I don't get the easy way out, so I'm pretty tough. But so I gave the questionnaire. It's some people call it compatibility test. It's really not. It's more about comparing people's experiences and seeing how they fit together. And when we did that, you two remember, you kind of scored in the higher percentiles on about everything. So that told us from the beginning that the two of you were made for each other. And we know that all of us here today, you know, if anybody here knows these two, you know that they fit together pretty well in a lot of ways. You know, a lot of your gifts and talents. And I think a lot of your family values fit together. And so you're young. A lot of people would say you two are too young to get married. Maybe a few people told you that. I don't know. But I don't know. I don't think so. You're probably one of the youngest couples I'll marry this year, though. I'll say that. So no pressure on you there. But you know, most people are a little bit older when they get married today. I guess it takes them a while to figure all that out, which is fine. But I do have a lot of confidence in the two of you. Your family does. You know, Larry said that it's hard to get your daughter away to a young man. Probably one of the hardest things a man will ever do. But he was pretty confident giving her to you. Because, you know, Larry trusts you, I guess. He does. You say he's over there. Of course he does. But, no, in all seriousness, he does. And the same thing would be true about your parents. You know, Casey, they trust giving you to this girl, this young lady. And like I said, the two of you are young, but you have a lot of good values. And you just didn't get those from out of the sky. You know, they came to you in a natural progression by the way that you were raised. And that fit together pretty well. You came from a mom and dad that loved you, loved each other, and you had a good family together. So we have a lot of confidence that the two of you can do that because you've seen what it's like. And that is a credit to the four of you, to your parents, who have done so much for you and helped you in so many ways. I always think, you know, at a person's wedding, that's one of the things that you should do more than anything, is give thanks to your parents. Not only for, you know, paying for things, the practical stuff, but for what they taught you. You know, we don't think about all that when we're growing up a lot of times. We take it for granted. But it's at times like this that we appreciate that. And sometimes we may not appreciate all that they did, especially when they had to get on us, you know, and discipline us. But now we do. We appreciate that. And the greatest gift that your parents gave to you was their love for each other and their faithfulness to each other. Because you always had that to fall back on. You know, a lot of people don't. But you do. Therefore, we expect more of you.
results of you, but the results of your parents and your grandparents. It goes real deep in those families of yours. So what you've come to do today, like I said, although you're young, and some people would say too young to get married. Heck, people used to get married a lot younger. But I believe your family does, and you're prepared for that. You know? You don't have it all together, you're not perfect, nobody is. But if you continue to trust in God and His grace and love one another each day, you will do well. You'll grow old together, like your parents had, not that old. They enjoy their life together. And that's a good thing. You know? And you knew I had to say something about this, but these two are both also hard workers. You surprised at that? Go ahead and laugh. You know? That's one good thing. You know, I have a wedding. At least I got all you guys off work for a day. You know, coming here to celebrate. But that's about the only way to get you guys to get away from work. But anyway. That's what Grandma Nelson told me last night. That of course they can't say much because they tend to work a little bit too. But so these things are important. Hard work is important because it also translates into a lot of prayer and a lot of fun. You know, that's what I find about people around here. People do well. They work hard. They play hard. They pray hard. They end up pretty good. You keep that together. Don't lose any of those things, though. You'll do well. We can guarantee that. You know, God can guarantee that. So, I know I'm teasing you guys a little bit about all that, but it's true. You know, you guys keep working hard, praying hard, and playing hard. And life will be good. You'll enjoy it. And that's what it's meant to be. You know, marriage is meant to be something that's enjoyed and celebrated, not something that's a drudgery. Too many people feel about it like that. Oh, why do I want to get married? Because I want to find joy and happiness. You know, that's why. And that's our prayer for the two of you, that you will find that what God wants for you. He wants joy and happiness. So we're going to invite you now to come share your vows with each other.